Hey, what's up guys, and welcome back to the AC Milan Career Mode, episode 7 today. And it's a January transfer window, which is good. We need to invest in some players because we're not performing as well as we should. So we'll just show what games we've got first. So we've got 5, Sampdoria, Calagria, Stabia, Udinese, and Brescia. We'll try get them all in one in this episode, but obviously being within the transfer window, we are going to try and make some signings. So plus playing games, we'll see how far we can get through January. If not, we'll split it into 2 episodes. But while we've been off camera, I've made a few adjustments to the transfer hub. So we need looking at a new left back, because obviously we've sold Rodriguez and legs out to Arsenal, so the left side is a little bit low in depth. Excuse me. So I have put a few players on. I'm waiting for their scout reports to come back, so that will take a couple of days. But we've got about a week before January starts. So hopefully reports will be back in by then. But I'll just show you. So the centre backs are from where we were at the start of the season, so we'll keep them in there. I've got Jorge from Monaco, the Brazilian left back. Rosaline, I think that's how you pronounce his name, from Wolfsburg. Sink Graven from Bayern Leverkusen. Oh, he's just joined because he was at Ajax, wasn't he? So I'll remove him. So it wouldn't be going for him. The other two are fine. Tagliafico. I'll have to try and see how to pronounce his name. But a very good left back at Ajax. They say they won't sell him, but if we do go for him, we'll try. But I don't know if we'll be able to. Junior Firpo from Barcelona. Another very good left back. Lodi from Atletico Madrid. Alaza from Celta Vigo. And Mateus Oliveira from Getafe. So all really good, strong left backs. So we're just waiting for their reports to come back. And then we'll decide on which one we want to go for. Dominguez is a player that I really want to get, but he's just joined Bologna. So I'll wait till next season to sign him, but I will sign him because he's a player that I want to use in FIFA. Okay, and then we're going to go to the centre attack mids now, just because I think we're lacking in creativity. I know Chanelogi's done really well, and I don't want to take him out of the team because he's probably our star player at the minute, but I do think we need to have a bit more creativity in the final third. So I've added Coutinho, Rodriguez, Odegaard, and Isco to the list. So something to think about here. This player's out on loan, not be available at the transfer negotiations. Okay, so Rodriguez we can sign. Odegaard is out on load. On loan, sorry, to Sociedad, I believe. And an Isco is available as well. Very pricey though, so we might have to wait till next season, but we'll see. And then we've got the strikers still in the list that we had from the start of the season. The only ones I have added is En-Nesyri from Seville and Luka Jovic from Real Madrid, who has recently joined, but as potentially we could get him on loan. But obviously, like I said at the start, my main target for me is Isaac. But we'll wait till the reports come back for En-Nesyri and Ljovic, and then we'll make a decision there. The only thing, one thing I do want to show you, when I added Coutinho to the list, is that we can approach the sign now. So he's on 145,000. 210,000, 30,000 wage, 220. So out of Rodriguez and Isco, he's cheaper, but Odegaard is a hell of a lot more. But Odegaard's on loan, but I would have to pay a transfer fee, where Coutinho, there wouldn't be no transfer fee. Excuse the dog, apologies. So we're going to approach to sign Coutinho, I think, for next season. Because why not? I know he played for Inter Milan. He's not doing very well at Barcelona. He's not going to stay at Bayern Munich, where he's at loan to now. So it's a club that he needs a club to go to. So let's try him. Well, that's very annoying. So it tells you that you can approach the sign, but you can approach the sign because he's out on loan. And that's very annoying. All right, never mind. We'll go into January. We'll play the first game, and then we'll make our first sign in January. Okay, just as we approach January, we've had confirmation of Rodriguez, who has been sold to Manchester United. So we've got another 12 million to the transfer budget, which is good. I'll show you the transfer budget in a second. Another good news is Romagnoli's returned from injury, which is very good. We've missed him very much. And then we've just had information from Villarreal that they play the release clause of Calabria. And I don't really want to sell him. So what I'm going to have to do is get him on a new deal so he doesn't leave the club, because he's a player that I want to keep at the club. He's been here a very long time and he's not someone that I want to sell. So he's on 27,000 a week. So if we delegate renewal, start off at 35,000. And no more than 50. Brilliant, there we are. 35,000 a week on a 4-year deal. No release clause. Calabria stays at AC. So we finally now have entered January. So into the transfer market. We haven't had any reports back yet. Well, I think there's maybe a couple coming in now. But what we'll do, we'll play 2 seconds. Let's see what we're playing sim in this episode. We'll sim Sampdoria, play Calabria, and we'll play Stambia, and then we'll see if we'll play these two games after the Stambia game and the transfer market to see where we're at. So let's simulate the game against Sampdoria. We're gonna keep this formation for now. Yeah, I'll keep this formation for now. The thing I'm going to do is Calabria for Castiello. Oh, hang on. Forgot Romagnoli's fit as well, isn't he? So let's get him back into the team. There he is. Bring him in for Musacchio. Make him skipper. Cool, right, let's jump into the simulation against Sampdoria. Right, hopefully we can start the episode with a win against Sampdoria at home. And we do. Brilliant. Bonaventura and Doniel Marlin. His first goal in a while. It's good to see Zlatan may come on as well for Rebic. A very good start to the episode. Oh, what I'm going to show you is the transfer budget as well, sorry. Transfer offer from Romagnoli from FC Bayern Munich. I don't want to sell him, he's our skipper. I know I said I want to keep this Primo really realistic, but at this meantime, he's going nowhere. Okay, It looks like the scout reports have all come back now for the strikers and the left backs. But what we'll do first, Dortmund have made an offer for Inaki Williams of $37.5 million. Okay. And Matheus Oliveira has been approached by West Ham. So that's something we need to look into if we want to give one of those players. But we'll jump against Calabria first, and then we'll look at these signings. Hoping in our first play game of the episode, we can get a 3 points that can follow up from the simmed game where we got 3 points. Our team remains the same, kept it the same as the win against Sampdoria. So I'll just show you the Cagliari team first. Cagliari, so that's what we called. Well, Kelly in centre back to play. He plays with Crystal Palace. Nangolan still playing in midfield. Simone Nandez and Palocci playing through the middle. Hopefully we can set off with a win. Nangolan, Simone. It's Pellegrini. We're on Calabria. Just signed a new deal for us. Now we can break through Bonaventura. Sees Rebic, he's through. Rebic, oh, good save. And we'll kept. Oh, mistake. Rebic to Marlon. Marlon makes it 1-0. A mistake there by Caligiuri. Rebic picks up and finds his teammate, Donya Marlon, to make it 1-0 to AC. That's 2-2 now for Donya Marlon. Hopefully, he can kick off and into in that run of form. But yeah, 1-0 AC. Nandez. Migani trying to get over. Does. Concedes a corner. First corner of the game for Caligiuri. Taking short. Crosses. To Nangolan. Oh, wasteful. Marlon well played to Calabria. Sees Rebic. Finds Rebic. Can he score? He does. It's a lethal counter attack by AC there. Another mistake by Calligiuri. Pounced on by Marlon. He then helps the assist the pass to Rebic. He finds the back of the net. 2-0 AC. Oh, we're through again. Theo Hernandez to Rebic. Oh, bad pass. If that was the right pass, then that could have been game, set, and match. Well defended, Çalhanoğlu. He's done it again. Donna. Very good saving, but on the ball. Passes he makes are terrible. Second corner. Oh, away, please. Away, Hernandez. Well done. One on Donya Marlon collects it. He's got the pace to get away. He has. Donya Marlon finds Theo. He's got no options. He strikes it. Good save. Donna? Jesus. Why don't you just let that pass? Why am I keeping it on? Bonaventura. Lovely ball over the top to Calabria, who can get there. Oh. Wanna call it? Nope. Throw in. Pellegrini getting forward, crosses. Oh, slight mix up in the defence. Lucky to get it away. We can break. Look, we have all game, and now it's Calabria. Still going. Calabria. Oh. Just wide. Defender gets back just to knock it past the post. Zlatan and Paqueta entering the field. Çalhanoğlu and Theo Hernandez making way. Rebic will go to the left. And Zlatan will play through the middle. But corner ball, Paqueta. Oh, Kaya again. Just can't direct it. I'm awful at corners. I swear this FIFA is the hardest FIFA to score headers. I think I've only scored one or two. Rebic to Zlatan. To Marlon. Oh. Defending against Calabria. Bonaventura can strike them. Blaze it over the top. Golan picks out a pass to Pellegrini. Calabria is trying to recover. Doesn't get there. Away Kaya. Striker gets in front but can't quite hit the target. Nandez with a header. Good to see Romagnoli on the pitch. Quetta. Actually, it's Paqueta. Watched the AC Milan game the other night. When they lost to Spal, I think. Paqueta. Oh. Yeah, and it's pronounced Paqueta. Very close there with his header. Blow the whistle, please, ref. And there we are. Very good performance today by us. Probably one of the most enjoyable performances I've played in a long time. Free flowing football, scored two goals, created a lot of chances, and kept another clean sheet. Very good 3 points. Let's do some training before we look at the transfers for the left backs. And I also will show you the transfer budget, as I was meant to do before the last game. Right. Transfer budget, let's have a look. So the sale of Luxalt and Rodriguez during the season, plus the money we didn't spend at the start of the season, our current budget is, well, I won't be using that much wage, 200 let's say, 68 million. So I think we need to make some transfers. So let's have a look. Okay, so we've got the reports back. So Jorge, or Jorge, 77 overall, but he has just moved club to Nunes. Bit of a random change for Monaco. Not too sure they play in the Brazilian league. Don't think they do. So it's a bit random. Rosalyn from Wolfsburg, who looks very good. Tagliafico from Ajax, very good player. Firpo from Barcelona, looks very good for his age, at 80 overall. Lodi, very good player from Atletico Madrid. Alaza, at 75 overall, don't think is going to be very good and going to quite cut it, so I'm going to remove him. And Matheus Oliveira has gone to West Ham, so I'll remove him. So it's going to be out of the other five. Oh, that we decide to pick from. So yeah, between the next five. So, well, Jorge's gone, so I'm gonna have to remove him. It's between Lodi, Firpo, Tagliafico, Mosolin. Yeah, and that's it. So let's have a look at their stats. He's very good. They're all very good, but his stats overall is very, very good. What is he, 6 foot? 5 foot 9. Okay, high and medium work rates. Again, very strong. Technically very good as well. Solid player. 5 foot 8, high work rates. Firpo, not as good, obviously, but he's a little bit low overall, but he's obviously a lot younger. Technically very good though. Early crosser. 6 foot. Lodi, 5 foot 8. Very good stats there. Technically very good as well. It's interesting. Okay. We've got to look at the wage as well. 150 million for 15 million? 1,000 Therapo. Don't really want to pay that much. We might be able to get him a lower deal. Hmm. 27, 27, 23, and 21. Right. As you can see with Firpo and Lodi, because they're still very young, the only way you can negotiate with them players is by paying their release clause. So their release clause is 35 million. That's going to be more than Tagliafico and Rosalind. So I am tempted. To go for one of these, but which one? Rosalind's cheaper in value by 5 million, but his wages is a little bit more. Rosalind can play left mid. I'll go for Rosalind. Only reason why is he can play left mid. And with the formations changing that I'm doing at the moment in time, if we do play the 3-3-5-2 formation, the left side he can play there with no problem. I know Hernandez is one of my favourite players, but we do need a backup because if we're in Europe next season, if. We need cover there, so it's good competition as well. So we're going to try and go for Rosalind here. We're going to offer the 20 million that he is valued at and see what they say. Okay, 32.7. So that's still less than Lodi and who was the other left back? Oh, I can't remember. Can't remember. Anyway, still cheaper. So, we'll see if we can negotiate a bit more. We'll go 25 and a half. We'll see what they say. It's not bad. 27.3. So they're coming down. Can we negotiate 27? 27 million for Rosalind. And we have. So, agreements between both clubs for 27 million for Rosalind have been agreed. We just now need to negotiate with the player to hopefully he can agree a deal for him to join the club. Right, he wants crucial. Try and change that to important. See if he will. No. Okay, so crucial player, it's fine. Four-year deal. Hopefully he'll sign that. Yeah, he likes that, it's good. We discard release clause. He's happy with that. Wages, so he's on 56. Try and be cheeky and offer him 50,000 a week wage with a 200,000 signing bonus. And there we are. Rosalind has joined the club. New left back. 82 overall. Very happy with that. 27 million. Very good signing. Club offer for Calabria here from Seville. We reject because we want to keep him. So yeah, let's jump into this game against Stabia. We'll make one more signing. And then we'll probably end the episode. But I'll just show you, we've had an offer in for Çalhanoğlu here from Everton for 19.5 million, which is his actual wage. His value. He's valued between 14 and 21 million. I want to keep him, but when a Premier League team like that come in, how can I not negotiate, you know? He would probably be open to move to Everton. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to delegate. So I'm not going to sell him for less than 25 million. I know they said around 21 was his value, but I don't want to lose him for 21 million. 25 max. And we'll start the bidding at 28.5. Yeah, 28.5. And let's see, if they happy with that, to pay that, okay, he can go. I know, like I said, he's a very good player and he's one of my favourite players. But I want to keep this career mode quite realistic. We're not in Europa League at the moment. I think Everton probably are, maybe. We're not in Champions League. I know Everton aren't. But they probably will be pushing the next couple of seasons. Bit like ourselves, but every player would probably like to play in the Premier League. So let's see what they say. They might not accept it, but yeah, let's jump into this game against Stabia at home in the Coppa Nazionale. Here we are then, first game, first round in the Coppa Nazionale. There's a competition we want to win. Obviously the league we're not going to win, nowhere near it. As you can see there, Muslin, number 3, he's going to make his debut today. The squad is rotated. Just want to give a few players a game and also rest a few players against a team that aren't in our league anyway, so we should win this. So I'll just show you the teams now. So Begovic in goal. Playing a 4-2-3-1. Muslin at left back, Musacchio, Duarte and Conti. Benesia and Biglia to hold him. Çalhanoğlu, Paqueta and Sailmakers, and Liao at top. Çalhanoğlu is playing on the left. I know he's been playing a lot of games, but that spot was kind of needed to fill in, so he's in good form. He's fit to play, so I'll play him. I don't know too much about Stabia, so hopefully we can just change that off training. Had to change remotes because my remote batteries had died. So, but no, I don't know too much about Stabia, so hopefully there won't be too much of a challenge for us, but you never know. Hopefully we can make it into the next round of the Coppa Nazionale. It's a competition that we do want to win, because like I said, we're not going to win the league this season, So a good cut run would be ideal. Is Sial Makers, who has recently joined AC Milan on a permanent deal from his loan. Ooh. Well defended, first corner of the game for AC. But also gives a chance to some of these youngsters and players that haven't played first team much first team football this season to show me why they should be playing. And that's not why they should show me why he's playing. Is it counted? Yeah, it has, yeah. And that's not a great start at all. Stabia take the lead at the San Siro. Left over well decepted. Liao, well, pressing forward. Oh, can't quite find the pass. He'll win the header. Biglia, how have you not scored? 6 yards out. Smash it straight to the keeper. Oh, they're in. What was my defending doing? And there's two. Awful defending. For some reason, Duarte, and Musacchio just ran forward towards the ball when the ball was going towards them. Not the half we were looking forward to. Milan 0, Stabia 2. Venezia. Done well to hold off the challenge. Paqueta, Salmakers. Oh, good defending again. 2 minutes to go to half time. There's half time to forget. Not very good at all. Changes need to be made, which are going to be made at half time to hopefully bring this game back to level and hopefully winning. Rosalind getting forward. Corner ball to AC. Oh, Zlatan, big chance, and he's fluffed it. Good start to the second half. Still no goals. Still remains 2-0 Stabia. Conte driving forward. He's received it from Zlatan. Conte, no options, he had to shoot, couldn't pull it back to anyone. It's an awful corner. Biglia get there? Nope. He's won the throw in. Rosalyn to Paqueta. Zlatan, that's poor. Go make a change. Biglia coming off. Castiello. 15 minutes to go. Obviously, Begovic. We have not been nowhere near as good as we should have been today. I know I've rotated the team, but wow. Everything, everyone's been slow. Passing's been awful. It's not a performance I expected. Like that there, Leal, make a run. Latan's waiting for you to make a run. You just stood next to him. Oh, poor defending. What a Musashio. Defending today has been wayful. Duarte and Musashio. Musashio hasn't done too bad, but Duarte has been awful. Strikers, where are we? Conti to Castiello. Paqueta. Oh, good chance, but was it a save? It might have been a save. Yeah, it was. It was on target as well. Can we get a consolation goal? Offside. That just wraps up today. That, how can you be offside there? You're watching the line, steps over the line to be offside. Never mind. Massive disappointment there. Like I said, we wanted to win this cup. We're not going to win the league this season. We're fighting for fourth. This on the side would have been a very good season if we won, plus getting fourth. Well, bit of an odd episode. Good two wins at the start. Transfer window so far has been good with a new left back, but a very disappointing result in the Coppa Nazionale. I'll just show you the table. So we still remain in sixth with 8 points behind Napoli. Juventus still top unbeaten with 57 points. Fourth is Atlanta with 44 points, so 9 points off of them. So still doable, but a hell of a challenge ahead. So that will end today's episode. Next episode we'll have Udinese at home, I think, and then Brescia away, plus the end of the transfer window, where we will be making another signing. Who? Not sure, depending on the Çalhanoğlu deal. Thank you all for watching. Excuse the bangs and the dog barks. It's a full house today, so it's been quite hard to upload, but it's the only time I've had the chance to do it. Again, apologies for no recent update through the week. Just been super busy with work and home life, so I will keep doing this episode series. Like I said before, it's just going to be not as regular as I'd like to. But yeah, give me your feedback on players who think I should sign. And hopefully the next upload won't be too long. But two games, plus the end of the transfer market in the next episode. Stay safe, enjoy the pubs. Don't get too drunk. Follow the government guidelines, of course. Stay safe, and I'll see you in the next episode.